Hello, how you feeling today?
Weird.
Feeling weird?
Weird.
Have you been listening to the stream at all?
Yeah, I was. I was listening to the stream.
Yeah, what do you think about it?
I don't know, weird. Just weird.
How do you feel about toxicity on the internet and stuff like that?
That it can't be stopped.
It can't be stopped?
Nope.
Why do you think it can't be stopped?
Everything's
going
to change for like a week, and then it's going to go back to normal.
Now that I agree with.
It's going to go back to normal.
But why do you think it can't be stopped?
Because just like, you can't change the fundamental of a person. Only they can do that to themselves. That's just how they are.
So you're saying fundamentally, humans are at their core going to hurt other humans.
Yeah,
either with words.
Are cruel. Yeah.
Interesting. Interesting. So, what do we do about that? I'll give you my two trains of thought. Either somehow stop people from being that way, being cruel and mean and hurtful, or better prepare people to deal with it when it does happen. So, I feel like there's two ways to, you know, try and fix that, you know, or both. That's right. Both will be great. But, you know, if one succeeds, the other one won't have to exist. Right. I also think, and this extends to myself as well. I think a lot of us have a hard time admitting when we're at fault and we're part of the problem. Like even right now, LSF can't see that they've done anything wrong. You know, some of them can. But majority of people there, like there's a thread right now saying, well, I can't believe, you know, people want to leave the thread. It's not LSF's fault. You know, things like that. It's even right now. They still don't get it. So
there's a thread. There's a thread about what I tweeted about yesterday. Did you see that? In their tweet, they're saying that they're considering letting people opt out, but per moderation team.
Wait, you're on their thread?
No, I tweeted yesterday that there should be an opt out. Mm-hmm. Because of all the bullying. Like, I don't want to be on LSF.
Someone says, the problem is that something worse is going to take LSF's place with much less moderation. See, I don't believe that. And that's like one of the top comments on the thread right now. If streamers made one and streamers policed it, like, you know how people are with their $3 TTS donations. They love getting attention from streamers. They love it. It's their middle name. Okay? So if we made the Reddit and gave it attention, the proper sort of attention, then no, a worse one wouldn't take its place. Now, maybe it would down the line, but do you know how hard it takes and how long it takes to grow things? It would take forever for it to grow. And then eventually the same thing will happen that happened to this current LSF. It'd get too toxic. So, you know, if there's just like a second one that wasn't moderated or something like that. So streamers can't moderate it correctly. See, I don't believe that at all. I don't believe that at all. I mean, apparently, the people running LSF right now can't moderate it correctly. So can anyone moderate it correctly? Streamers? Randoms? You know, Twitch? I don't know. Jeff Bezos? Can anyone do it right? So apparently, the one that they're having right now isn't doing a good job. And we had nothing to do with that one. So you can't really say it unless we give it a try, right? But then again, I mean, if they want to have, like, a new dawn, I'm down to see what they can do, really, to be honest, so.
I'm sorry for your loss. Asman said to start and ban toxic people from every chat, so if one is toxic in your friend's chat, you also ban them from your community. It's a small step,
that's
but it's
like,
a step.
Wait. Sorry, but that's so hypocritical because Greek was doing that, and you guys were all literally...
Isn't that exactly what Greek said to do?
That is so hypocritical.
Isn't that exactly what Greek Greek and Train got shit on for? Like... I talked about building a program that could do just that. And people lost their minds. So if someone's being toxic, like, hey, Greek, you're fat, you suck, big ego, that guy gets banned. That's what he was trying to ban people for doing, which they're being toxic, but everyone lost their minds. And now it's okay all of a sudden.
I don't know. I think of
because
it this
Asmund Gold
I think
it.
Of it this way, right? Let's say we're throwing a party, right? And someone at our party is behaving like a dick, and we know that they're a dick, and they're about to go over to our friend's party. Do you warn your friends and get them out of their party before, like, they go over there and spread more
toxicity? People are saying Greek abused it. How? So someone being toxic to Greek, how did he abuse it? He didn't ban strangers. He banned toxic people. He didn't abuse anything. He banned people he viewed as toxic. It was criticism. Hey, you suck. You have a big ego. That is criticism. You can't joke. Well, no shit, you can't joke. These people aren't your friends. Who are you joking with? Imagine going into Wendy's. Hey, your food sucks. Hey, you suck at cooking those nuggets. What?
Nmplol said, spread the love.
You ban people for no reason sometimes. No, I don't believe you. I don't believe that. I don't believe that Greek just randomly selected people randomly and banned them randomly. I don't believe that. I believe that they said something to Greek that upset him and they got banned for it. It wasn't just random. Okay, if that's the case, all right, I'm going to pick a random name in the hat. So this is what he did. Let me get this straight. Random name. Okay. All right, boom. Low riding dog. You said me in the chat. You are now banned in all my friends' chats as well. Is that what he did? Low riding dog. Is that what he was doing? Or maybe low riding dog came in the chat and was like, hey, what's up, 2K Andy, bitch. Maybe he did that. You know what I'm saying?
I'm sorry.
You know what I'm saying? I do not believe he just banned people for nothing. There had to have been something. Now, you might deem the offense not offensive. You might think 2K Andy is an okay thing to say to somebody. But when you're all like when you're dropping viewers, you're already, you know, it hurts. And then you have someone coming in here poking you. What about joking and banter? How is 2K Andy banter in the slightest, mate?
Dude, bantering is with your friends. I'm gonna be honest.
How is that?
That's like a stranger walking up to you at the mall and being like saying something rude to you, you know? Like,
oh, for sure, dude. You're right.
It's bantering is with your friends, and you have to be invited to banter.
Like let's just say like one day, like I don't even know what good banter is because I'm so bad at it. Like,
I don't understand sarcasm because English is my second language.
How do you banter with somebody?
Oh,
what's that? What's that? Michael Scott's
quote. Me and you
banter
all the time.
Do we?
Yeah.
Okay, so the chicken legs thing, that's banter, right?
Yeah.
So
yeah.
We since we're friends with the Greek, we can be like, hey, nice chicken legs. But imagine if you saw a stranger in public who had chicken legs like train, and you walked up to him like, hey, nice chicken legs.
How are you gonna use train as an example? That's so rude.
but I can do that because we're friends.
Yeah, but still, you did not hesitate one second to pull his chicken legs out of the freaking...
But we're friends. I can do that. But Twitch chat thinks they're friends with the streamer. It's some sort of delusion.
Ow. Yeah, but...
It's crazy. Like, I'm not going to walk up to Scott Disick like, hey, Scott, nice chicken legs, bitch, because I watch your show all the time. I don't understand.
That's I can definitely put myself in the position of being a viewer because I have been the viewer before. Like I was anonymous for like 5 years, watched a lot of streamers, met them at events. They had no idea who I was, but I knew a lot about them that they didn't know. And I got into all these Twitch parties because of Nick and because of Chance. And I met all the people that I was watching and they had no idea who I was, but I knew more about them just as much as you guys know about us. And it's a very weird position to put yourself in. You have to, you can't just walk up to someone and talk to them like you know them. You have to like approach someone like they don't know you.
You are broadcasting to us. Don't compare us to strangers on the street. What do you mean? Are the Kardashians not broadcasting to us as well? The only difference now is you can type in the chat. It's no different. And I can respond right away. But think of it this way. So the same thing that happens with people like me and you being able to banter, I'm going to tell you this right now. Not all viewers are the same. Like I said earlier, Ube Du can say things to me because I know where he's coming from, that some of you can't. All viewers aren't even the same either. You can't just walk up to someone randomly that you don't even know. Like, I talk to Ube all the time.
It's because,
like,
we know stream. He's not, bottom line, he's not ill-intentioned. Like, he does not mean any harm.
Well, first off, he does want me to change because he thinks I'm pathetic, which true, is fine because he's not wrong.
Thank you, Ube, for helping me prove point. Thank you. What?
Okay. Like, the same thing with Like, you guys all know the donator, right? Has built up a repertoire of being able to say her opinion and not get, like, you know, banned for it because they're here. They're not some random person just floating through the wind. They're part of the community. You know what I'm saying? Stuff like that. Her? Yeah, I'm convinced it's the girl.